Hello, Steve Dotto here. I'm glad you're joining me today. Today's topic, we're going to do another online file sharing and backup service. But I know I sort of promised that after we did the whole Dropbox comparison to Google Drive trilogy, that I would that was that for as far as that goes. And that's that as far as comparing those two. I'm not going to compare those two. But I am going to show you another service, one that I've used for a very long time and I quite like. And the reason I quite like it is it really deals well with the whole issue around backing up your data. Now, when we posted those videos on Dropbox and Google Drive, the number of people that wrote into me and said, this is all very well, Steve, these are great services, but you've got to tell people there's a difference between file sharing and backup, that these are not backup services. They still have to back up their data. And that was a point that I took to heart. And so I wanted to show you iDrive now, because iDrive is a file sharing service that also has a backup component. They really concentrate on the side of the backup. And I've used them for quite a while. They've been around for a long time. They've been around for 4 or 5 years. They've got over 2 million subscribers. I feel they're a good, stable company, so I have no trouble talking about them, knowing, and, you know, with the understanding that they're going to be around and be able to serve my audience for quite some time to come. So, iDrive. What are the differences between it and Google Drive and Dropbox? Primarily, iDrive does the file sharing that we see in the other services, but it doesn't concentrate on that as its only revenue line. It also does backup, proper backup, and they provide some exceptional additional tools to make your life easier. Here's the issue with backing up, and the reason a lot of people don't back up is the first backup, the initial investment of backup. And I'm not talking money. I'm talking time and bandwidth. If I'm backing up my hard drive and I've got 200 gigabytes of data on my hard drive, it could take me, depending on the speed of my internet, till my next birthday to do that first backup. And depending on the quality of or the contract I have with my ISP, it might end up costing me extra money because I might go over my data plan for that particular period. So that initial backup can be quite a hassle. Well, they get around that with iDrive because when you sign up for one of their larger plans, and I'm talking 300 gigabytes, which is their basic plan, but it's a large amount of data. When you sign up for that, they will ship you, at their expense, a hard drive, which you run their backup software on, ship it back to them, again, at their expense. They ingest all of your data into their system. Then when you log into your account, you do an incremental backup, which is just a small amount of information, the amount of information that you've saved on your computer in the last few days, basically. And then you're into incremental backup, and you've got the best of both worlds. You've got a good solid online backup. Of course, you should be still backing up physically in your own location as well. But you're covered off and you haven't spent hours and days waiting for all of this data to upload to the internet. Now, if disaster strikes, which we hope it doesn't, they will ship you for free again that hard drive or a hard drive where they've done a disk image of your latest backup back to you so that you can just run that disk image and then restore your new computer with your old data very, very quickly and efficiently. Again, if you were to have to download all of that information, it could take a considerable amount of time. Typically, it won't take as long as it takes to upload it because download speeds are faster. But still, you're gonna be up and running that much quicker. So I like it for those reasons. It does most of the other things that we see within Dropbox. It doesn't do everything Google Drive does because it doesn't have all the apps side. But as far as file sharing, it does pretty much all the same stuff. So let me just show you their pricing options. And they set up, you can try it out for free. And when you do try it out for free, they've got all of those little social media perks that all of the others do. If you get a friend to sign up, you get an extra half a gigabyte of data. If you share on Facebook that you've signed up with them, you get some extra data. So you've got all of that kind of fun stuff to help grow the game side of the early one. And they start with 5 gigabytes free, which is enough for you to get a feel for how the service works and how their interface works. But to be honest, you're not going to have any trouble because it works pretty much identically to everybody else. A nice, clean, simple file backup sharing interface and syncing interface. So this is the plan that I like. They've got a yearly plan of $25 a year, and that gives you 300 gigabytes of data, and they will ship the hard drive to you and then ship it back in that price. So it's a great deal for individuals. I think that's the perfect plan, and they've got incremental bumps in storage from that particular point. But let me show you the software itself. So when I launch iDrive, I'll just start it. So typically, as is all of the other cases, there's an app that can run on your computer. You can run it as a web app, and you also have the ability to run it. It installs right in your menu bar or in your taskbar, so it's there for you all the time. In the backup environment, it's pretty straightforward. You select what files or what documents, what folders from your computer that you want to have backed up. Tell them to back it up, and it will then back up that data, that amount of data. And it always tells you how much space you have left. Restore, it's a simple, you know, restore it back to your computer. The scheduler is really important, and you should spend some time setting up a schedule. And this is a really smart way to do it, is you just set it up. It backs up based on the schedule that you set. And I recommend doing it like 2 a.m. or something when you're not using your bandwidth. And then have it also email you either all the time, which is kind of a little OCD, I think, if you're having it email you every time a backup is successful. But this is quite useful, to have it email you if there's a failure. If your computer powers down for some reason because you have a power interruption or something like that and you're not properly backed up, having an email notification in that case, probably not a bad idea. Then we've got the ability to set up for sync, which is similar to Dropbox at this point. This is where we have files on our computer that we sync between multiple computers. And I like to always sync between my desktop and my notebook computer. And then this also is the area that we use for large file sharing, or for sharing files back and forth. So let me show you that. There it is. I want to go into my Finder. And so you see that I've got the iDrive folder here on my computer. And it's right next to Dropbox. And guess who's down here? Google Drive. It's the exact same. It's installed here in my Finder or in the operating system so that I can access it. And I can just drag files into it or drag files out of it. But the thing that we're going to want to do fairly regularly is take one of these files from within it, and we're going to want to share it. So when I right-click my mouse, as I've just done, up comes iDrive with web access to the file, sharing the file, and version control of the file. Sharing the file is what you're going to do the most. Now, how it works with the sharing interface is it actually launches your web browser at that point there, and it uses the web interface to manage sharing. But that's not really a problem. Up it pops in your preferred web browser, in my case here, Chrome. And I like this. You just click on the settings, and it allows me to put a password in for it, for the file, if I choose, because I'm sharing it with somebody and I don't want it to be just out there willy-nilly. And I can choose whether the person can view it or can edit the file. Once I've done that, I save those settings, and I'm able to send it by email to whoever it is that I'm sharing the file with. And yes, they can open the file without having to install iDrive. So it does pretty much everything that we need. Now, no backup and file sharing service is perfect. They all compete in different ways. But iDrive has been around long enough, as I said, and they've got a large enough user base that I believe they're a really stable business. They've got an excellent customer service reputation, and I think that they've got a nice balance. They honor the fact that we need to back up our data, as well as they recognize the fact that we want to be able to sync our files between multiple computers, and they've set up as simple a system as I can envision to hit both of those key points. Plus, they've done it at a reasonably good price point. So overall, I think that they're a contender. They might not be the champ, but they are a contender. And if you are concerned with backup and you don't have another backup system set up, you should possibly consider iDrive as a solution. I hope that you found this video to be useful. If you have, why not subscribe to our channel? If you're not subscribed, all you do is you click on the link above, and that will cause you to be subscribed so that every time we release a new video, you will be notified of our new video. And we're going to be producing new videos on an ongoing basis, and we hope that they will all be just as useful or possibly more useful than this one. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle!